Hi Blender fans, and welcome to Blender DC. In today's tutorial we're going to be making ourselves a neon sign, just like you get in a diner in America. So what I'm doing now is I'm just setting up this sign and just the bits and bobs that the neon sign is going to actually rest on. So as you can see, I'm just creating different shapes, mainly based on the cube and using a bevel just to actually get the round edges on them. And then just adding a bit of different colours to these just to get different slight effects. Right, like I said, we're making a neon sign and we're going to be using the text plus the curve. And like I said, using the curve and changing them into models and back again. And you'll see what I mean. Join me at the end of this tutorial. We'll actually show this in more detail. It's a bit slower pace. I mean, I don't think you can follow this. It's just a bit too quick. It is 52 minutes actually crammed down into less than 3 or 4, I believe. So, yeah. What I did next, I added a little bit of text and it said, American City. And I made it in exactly the same way. So I did the first text. And we're going to cover this at the end. Nice bright orange colour. And then move it back into place. Now I'm going to rotate this right diner. Rotate it by 90 degrees. Add the different effects. Thicken it up. I'm just adding the wires that go back through the actual sign. As you can see, oops, messed that up a bit, but I quickly fixed it. Yep. Quickly fixed. And then we actually change this into a curved object and then like solidify it. And back into an actual mesh object. As you can see, this is a quick and easy technique, and what I'm going to do is actually copying the edges there and I'm pulling them out and forward, then changing them into a curved object. Yep, there we go. Change it into a curved object, give it a bit of thickness, and then give it the neon look. So we've got the blues. I'm going to set up some colors here. It's going to be mainly blues and reds and oranges. There we go. And quite quickly, with very little work, you can actually achieve quite a good effect. Now I'll make this one red. I duplicated that and then actually moved them into the edges and moved them up slightly. And I'm going to duplicate that, rotate it 180 degrees, like so. And there you have it. Quick and easy. You've got a neon sign saying American City Diner, eat American City Diner. And let's just do this at a slower pace. Let's begin. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually quickly make scale this in the X direction, just make it and scale in the Z, and I'm just going to scale this in the Y just by moving my mouse button just to actually move this down. And what we can do now is quickly add a material to this. We just add a new material. And we'll just make it a little bit of dark material. The reason we're doing this is just going to be the backdrop of my sign, or my neon sign. And what we're going to add now is the neon sign. So I'll just move this back just out of the way, G and Y, just to move it towards the back, away from our neon sign. So I'm going to add in some text, and the text I'm going to add in is just my name. So text, or name of my channel, pressing the tab key. What you can do is go into edit mode. Oops, let's just put this on to render mode so it makes it a little bit easier to see Right, so I'm just going to spell. There we go. Oopsie daisy. Make the first one a capital. And DC. So there's some attributes we can actually alter in here. That's to one side. I want it to be in the center. I want it to be rotated by 90 degrees. So I'm going to rotate on the X by 90 just to make this into a, just to actually make it stand up. And what we've got here is we've got fill mode, but I don't want fill mode there. I just want these edges. So change fill mode to none. And as you can see, what we've got is we've got see-through text. But that'll be really useful for making our neon sign. So I'm just going to scale this up. And then what we're going to do is convert this into a mesh. Like that. And then what we'll do is we're going to actually, after we've converted into a mesh, we're just going to do a little bit of modeling. G and Y, just to actually, I'm just going to make the wires, you know, the wires that make up, I'm just making the wires that make up my sign. You know, the power in, the power out and things like that. Control Z. I'm just going to get rid of that line there. X. And delete the edge. Just to make up my, just getting my wires going. I'm just about had enough of this. What we're going to do is now just add in a, what we're going to do now is just actually change this back. So I'll go into object and convert this into a curve object. And that, of course, makes this little green lasso-y type thing appear again. And this allows us to actually go into this geometry here. And what we can do is set the actual resolution to whatever we want and set the thickness. And as you can see, a bit too thick. That's made our neon sign shape. But as you can see, this is a curved object. So we need to change this back object, convert, back to a mesh like that. And G and Y, just move it back into the wall. I'll move the wall to the text. So I've got my text, G and Z. Going to render mode. As you can see, there's next to no light. But all we're going to do now is actually make sure that we're actually in Eevee. Make sure ambient occlusion's on, bloom's on, screen space refractions. Not so much bothered about motion blur. And we're going to the material, adding a new material. And then instead of principal shader, we're going to use an emission shader. Like that. Up the strength to some reasonable. Change it into whatever colour you wish. And make it as bright or as dull as you want. So as you can see, we've made ourselves some neon lighting that you could use in your cityscape, or as I did in the diner sign earlier. Thank you for joining me on Blender TC, and please share my channel and subscribe. Bye for now. And of course, you can change the colours to whatever you want. And if it's too bright, just turn the brightness down by adjusting the strength. Bye for now.